So the next question. In a retail market, fruit vendors were selling mangoes kept in packing boxes. These boxes contained varying number of mangoes. The following was the distribution of mangoes according to the number of boxes. Find the number of boxes, mean number of mangoes kept in a packing box. Find the mean number of mangoes kept in a packing box. Number of mangoes are given as 50 to 52, 53 to 55, 56 to 58, 59 to 61, 62 to 64. And number of boxes are given as 15, 110, 135, 115 and 25. So we have to find the mean number of mangoes. So to find the mean number of mangoes, here we are going to apply the assumed mean method. Okay. Other than assumed mean method, there is a third method to find the mean. It is step deviation method. But CBSE has already deleted the portion. But still, we will try this question in that method. Step deviation method. STEP. Step deviation method. So we will do this question in that method. Okay. We can do the same question in direct method and also in assumed mean method. But we will try it with the step deviation. So for that also, we will write XI. XI is as usual 50 plus 52 by 2 which gives you 51. Again 53 plus 55 by 2 gives you 54. Again the next value will be 56 plus 58 by 2 which gives you 57. So here that you can see the difference as 3, isn't it? So the next value will be automatically it will be 60 and the last value will be 63. Write FI as given. FI is 15, 15, 110, 135. Then 115 and 25. So we wrote XI and FI. The next thing we do is we will calculate DI as we found for assumed mean method. So DI is XI minus A. So we have to assume one mean, isn't it? So we will assume the middlemost value as our mean, A as 57. So DI is 51 minus 57 which gives you the value minus 6. Again 54 minus 57 which gives you minus 3. 57 minus 57 which gives you 0. 60 minus 57 which gives you 3. 63 minus 57 which gives you 6. So here in the next step, if we were calculating the mean using assumed mean method, the next step will be FI into DI, isn't it? Since we are going with the step deviation method, we have another column UI. UI is equal to DI divided by H. DI is this value divided by H. H will be the common value in this column, the common number in this column. The common number in this column is 3, isn't it? So we will take the value of H as 3. So DI by H, can you say minus 6 by 3 gives you minus 2, minus 3 by 3 gives you 1, minus 1, 0 by 3 gives you 0, 3 by 3 gives you 1 and 6 by 3 gives you 2. So what we did is we wrote another column UI. UI is DI by H. H is the common of this column. The common element of this column is common number is 3. 6, 3, minus 3, 6, minus 6 are the numbers and the common term is 3. So we are taking H as 3. Again what we will do is in the mean method we calculated. In the direct method for calculating mean we calculated XIFI. In the assumed mean method we calculated FIDI. Then what will be the next column for the step deviation method? It will be FI into UI. So just calculate UI into FI. So 15 into minus 2, minus 30. Again, 110 into minus 1, which gives you minus 110. 135 into 0, 0. 115 into 1, 115. 25 into 2 gives you 50. Okay, again calculate sigma fi. Sigma fi will be sum of all these values and you are getting sigma fi as 400. Again calculate the sum of these values. 30 and 110 gives you 140, minus 140 and here it is minus 165. So sigma, it is positive 165 and here it is minus 140. So sigma fi ui is 25. Okay, so in assumed mean method after finding DIFI, we found out D bar. So here after finding UIFI, we will be finding U bar. U bar is equal to sigma FI UI by sigma FI. Sigma FI UI is 25. 25 by sigma FI is 400. Okay. Again, in assumed in the step deviation method, we have another formula to find the mean. Mean comma x bar is equal to a plus h into u bar. A plus h into u bar. What is a? A is the assumed mean, which is 57. Plus what is h? H is what we divided the common value, which is 3 into. What is u bar? U bar is 25 by 400. So 25 divided by 400. So this value will be 57 plus 3 into 25 is 75. 75 divided by 400 gives you the value 0.19. So the mean we are getting 57.19. So using the step deviation method, the method we applied here is step deviation method. Using the step deviation method, we got the mean value as 57.19. The same value which we will get for the mean if we apply the director method and also when we apply the assumed mean method. Okay.